Welcome to tonight's Titusville High School Senior Night. If I can have all of the senior parents come down and the senior athletes come forward. We would like to begin senior night by honoring the Northeast High School seniors. If Nathan Mays can come forward. Senior number 10, Trent Leonard. Senior number 21, Garrett Owens. Senior number 32, Andrew Wisneski. Senior number 33, Joel Kitchen. Cheerleader senior, Kira Vichek. Cheerleader senior, Ariel Seitz. Cheerleader senior Sarah Sesney. And cheerleader senior Brianna Elliott. From Titusville, Morgan Kemp, daughter of Vincent and Debbie Kemp. Morgan is a participant in marching band and treasurer of the drama club. After graduation, Morgan plans to attend Brockport, New York and major in psychology and minor in theater. Morgan's favorite memory is overcoming her fear of heights and went up in a bill during cheerleading. Senior Rachel Knupp, daughter of Chris and Greg Knupp. Rachel is a participant in track and yearbook. After graduation, Rachel plans to attend a four-year college. Rachel's memorable memory was when the cheerleaders came to help her with her senior project, raising over $2,000 to benefit the Anna Shelter and the Pleasantville Fire Department, flying with the girls and somersaulting with Raven. Raven Payne, daughter of Mary Hendrich. Raven is a participant in FCCLA, the speed team, being an night mentor, and a secretary of art club. After graduation, she plans to attend Clarion University for early childhood and special education. Raven's favorite memory is talking with Kelsey about the other team's shoes and how our team's shoes should match the school colors. Senior Kelsey Straub, daughter of John and Lisa Straub. Kelsey is a participant in dance, cheerleading, and is an Ignite mentor. Kelsey's favorite memory is when the student section was highly involved in the Northwestern game. Cheyenne Walters, daughter of Jeff and Cheryl Walters. Along with the basketball cheerleading, she is also cheered for football. She is also the treasurer for the art club. After graduation, Cheyenne plans to attend the University of Pittsburgh at Titusville and become a physical therapist assistant. Cheyenne's most memorable memory is being out most of her senior year due to having foot surgery. Cheyenne would also like to extend a special thank you to Leanne Lewandowski for everything she has done for her and the THS athletic students. Leanne has been a tremendous help to Cheyenne and many others, and we all will be forever grateful. Alex Vincent, son of Marie and David Vincent. Alex has participated in basketball for 2 years, baseball for 4, and is a member of Key Club. Alex plans to attend La Roche College and will study pre-med. His memories include the singing of all the bus rides. Alex wants to thank the coaches for allowing him to be a part of the team, even though he wasn't playing on the team. Drew Baldwin, son of Aaron Baldwin and Laura Strachan. Drew is participant in Key Club. After graduation, Drew will leave for the Air Force on September 13th and will pursue a career in cybersecurity after basic training. Drew's favorite memory is scoring his first varsity points and coming together as a team in District 10. Nathan Ciccarelli, son of Kim and Glenn Ciccarelli. Nathan is a participant in Key Club. After graduation, he plans to study criminal justice. Nathan's favorite memories are participating on the team as a freshman with his brother Corey and making playoffs, being selected for all tournament team and Corey, having my girlfriend pin my leg between two cars before we won the Christmas tournament, hitting the game-winning three-pointer against Fairview, and finally playing with my boys on the varsity team. Zach Edwards, son of Robert and Ellen Edwards. Zach is a participant in Key Club, National Honor Society. He also played soccer this year and swam for 3 years. After graduation, Zach plans to attend Penn State Barron for electrical engineering. Zach's memorable memories are scoring his first points in a high school game and to play with such an amazing team his first and last year of high school basketball. Tyler Gates, son of Brian and Crystal Gates. Tyler is a participant in Key Club and AAU basketball. After graduation, Tyler plans to attend Penn State Barron and major in mechanical engineering technology and to play college basketball. Tyler's favorite memories are throwing down dunks and having a great season this year. And last but not least, Zach Richards, son of Lisa Richards and Jeremy Stearns. Along with basketball, Zach participates in golf, baseball, and bowling. After graduation, Zach plans to attend college for graphic design. Zach's favorite memories are playing in his first varsity game, scoring his first basket against Harbor Creek, and bleeding all over the floor in Nate when he got elbowed in the eye. Titusville High School would like to extend a big thank you and congratulations to all of the senior athletes.
Again, senior night here at the Launch Pad, and tip-off coming up in just a few moments. This is Titusville Rocket Basketball on stream television. We'll be right back. And good evening and welcome to Senior Night here at the Launchpad. Tonight, the Titusville Rockets welcome the Northeast Grape Pickers. And it is great to be here. Senior Night, final home game of the regular season here at the Launchpad. And our coverage of Titusville Rocket basketball all season long has been made possible by these great supporters. Bayless Fuel Service, by State Farm Insurance, by Oil Creek Plastics, by the Colonial Machine Company, by Donovan and Bauer Auto Group, by Anderson Physical Therapy, by Big G Tire and Auto, by the University of Pittsburgh at Titusville, by Joe Taylor Ford, by Armstrong, by the American Legion, by Community Chevrolet, by Warm Home and Hearth, and by Titusville Area Hospital. And once again, good evening, live from the launch pad here tonight. It is senior night as the Titusville Rockets welcome the Northeast Grape Pickers. And we welcome Tim McCord. Coach, good to see you tonight.
Hey, it's great to be here again, Luke. Thanks so much for having me.
Big game tonight, just in the sense that it's senior night. It's the last home game here for the regular season. And a tight game the last time these two teams met.
It was a very close game, 62-54. The Rockets coming out on top. Rockets will have their hands full tonight with the big three from Northeast. Garrett Owens, Andrew Wisniewski, and Nathan Mays. All three had double figures the last time, with Owens leading the way with 16 points.
Again, looking for an exciting matchup here tonight. We're going to take our first time out, come back, and get you set for Titusville Rocket basketball. Again, the boys taking on the Northeast Grape Pickers. Our coverage will continue right after this.
Since Congress chartered the American Legion in 1919, the Cleo J. Ross Post 368 has been a major part of the Titusville community. The Legion promotes patriotism, honor, and committed devotion to our fellow service members and veterans. We also sponsor various programs such as youth wrestling. We offer scholarship awards and benefit dinners to aid our local community. The American Legion Cleo J. Ross Post 368 is here to make a difference at 113 East Central Avenue, Titusville. Anderson Physical Therapy is committed to your long-term health and well-being. With certified, licensed therapists, Andersons can provide therapy for all your rehabilitation needs. With our new location in Titusville at 202 Union Street and our new offices at 118 Main Street, Titty Ute, Anderson makes it convenient for you to get back to doing the things you enjoy. So stay on top of your game with Anderson Physical Therapy. Now in 7 locations and online 24/7 at andersonphysicaltherapy.net.
Right now, this moment, the way you watch TV can change. And not in the "I liked it more before" kind of way, but in the "how did I ever live without this" kind of way. EXP blends Armstrong services, creating a new experience, recording 6 shows at once. Stream programs to watch anywhere. Search to find your favorite actor, show, or movie. Record shows from anywhere. And it can start today. This is EXP, and this changes everything.
Bayless Fuel sells only ultra-low sulfur home heating oil. No matter what energy you use to heat your home, heating oil offers some distinct advantages. It is environmentally sound, biodegradable, non-toxic, and non-carcinogenic. We also offer BioHeat to be even more environmentally conscious. With dependable delivery from Bayless Fuel, you will have the fuel you need to stay warm and comfortable when winter rears its ugly head. Bayless Fuel is proud to carry products that deliver the quality and performance you expect. Call 827-3336 or visit us at 202 South Brown Street in Titusville.
And welcome back here to the launch pad. Just about 8 o'clock and just about time for tip-off. A late start tonight. The JV game went into overtime. Pretty exciting overtime win for the Rockets.
Yeah, 38-32, the Rockets came away with an exciting victory tonight. And this reminds me of the old days, Luke, when the JV game started at 6:30 and the varsity game started at 8 o'clock. We're right back to where we were many, many years ago.
Well, it's very exciting, and just like many years ago, this place is packed.
Oh, we have a great crowd tonight, probably about 3/4 full, and hopefully they'll see a great game tonight. I know the Rockets are coming off an outstanding win Wednesday night at Fairview, down to the buzzer with a little overtime game, and Nate Ciccarelli with a three-point basket to pull out the victory for the Rockets and vaulting them into first place in Region 4.
Yeah, very exciting game. What do you take away from a game like that? And these guys already have the confidence. So what do you take away when you're looking at the final couple games of the season?
Well, I think that builds their confidence even more because they knew the second half of the rotation through the region was going to be a tough rotation. All the tough teams, the toughest of the teams, were teams that the Rockets were going to face on the road with first Fairview, that we come back home as we see here tonight, and then we have Mercyhurst Prep next week on the road and finish up with Northwestern.
What are the other schools saying about Titusville when they're getting ready to play them? I mean, this is something that we haven't experienced in a little while, and it's great to see that Titusville has a very solid program and very talented kids.
Well, we're in a good stretch of players right now. The other teams, I'm sure what they're looking for is they know, number one, they've got to stop the big man in the middle. They've got to really play good defense. Both some will choose to stay behind Tyler Gates. Some will choose to front. Some may double team him when he gets the ball. But he's the first one you have to stop, I think, because if we get the ball inside, it makes our offense go. Second, we've got to put the kibosh to Kai Skinner, so to speak. And then finally, I think a couple players that are really overlooked. One is Nate Ciccarelli. Nate's had an outstanding year to this point.
Yes, he has.
And Brady Corklin also is a very capable scorer.
All righty, Mark Heim, camera operator. Tim McCord ready to do play-by-play. I'm Luke Rio. Thank you so much for joining us here. We've got tip-off coming up next. This is Titusville Rocket Basketball on Stream Television.
Big G Tire and Auto on the Hightown Road in Titusville is your home to the largest selection of tires for small compact cars to large semis. Need an oil change, inspection, or repair? Big G can service your vehicle while it's in the shop. Protect your vehicle with our fluid film undercoating to keep the rust at bay. Big G will keep you on the road.
Tires for any size vehicle and auto repair. Come see us at Big G Tire and Auto on Hightown Road in Titusville.
It's February, Groundhog's Day, Valentine's Day, and President's Day. To celebrate, we have the great President's Day sale.
On this Bighorn truck, stock number R039, take $10,000 off the sticker.
Take this Chrysler Town & Country and get up to $4,500 in rebates.
I am here today to accept the nomination of my party, not the donkeys or the elephants, but of the Ram Party for President of these United States. We will have Ronnie Care. Call me the Ronald.
It takes a lot for a community to be successful. Hard work, sacrifice, and the ability to take risks and go beyond your reach. This is nothing new for the residents here in Small Town USA, and it's certainly not new to the hundreds of student athletes who give their all on every level of play. From beginners to varsity to college and beyond, know that the Colonial Machine Company in Pleasantville is right behind you, supporting you all the way. Best of luck on the field and in life, the Colonial Machine Company.
Welcome to Titusville Area School District's presentation of Titusville Rocket Sports on the Stream.
And now the starting lineup for the Grape Pickers. Number 4, 6-foot guard senior Nathan Mays. Number 10, 6-foot guard senior Trent Leonard. Number 21, 6'3 forward senior Garrett Owens. Number 32, 6'3 forward senior Andrew Wisneski. And number 33, 6-foot guard senior Joel Kitchen. The Pickers are coached by Jason Kepine and assisted by Nick Haller, Stephen Reike. And now the starting lineup for your Rockets. Number 24, 6'2 guard junior Kai Skinner. Number 20, 5'10 guard junior Brady Corklin. Number 23, 5'10 guard junior Danny Snyder. Number 4, 5'11 guard senior Nate Ciccarelli. And number 50, 6'5 forward senior Tyler Gates. The Rockets are coached by Craig Mellenbacher and assisted by Rick Skinner.
And you can hear that atmosphere here at the launch pad tonight. An exciting matchup. Again, the Rockets welcoming the Northeast Grape Pickers. And we are set to go with tip-off. Coach, keys to a Rocket win tonight.
Well, as usual, we're going to have to take care of the basketball, get good shot selection throughout the night, and then, as always, good defense. Defense wins championships.
All right, and look at that crowd tonight.
Great crowd tonight, great crowd. Rockets open up with Ciccarelli, Corkland, Schneider, Skinner, and Gates. The great pickers, Mays, Leonard, Owens, Wisniewski, and Kitchen. Good size on this Northeast basketball team as they come out ready for the opening tip.
Yeah, we've heard a lot about this Owens kid.
I believe that he may be the young man that plays AAU basketball with Kai Skinner in the summertime. I'm not sure about that 100%, but he's out here jumping center with Tyler Gates. So here we are with the opening tip, and the Rockets will have the first possession. Northeast in their maroon uniforms opens up in man-to-man. Corkland with the basketball off of a screen from Schneider. Right away inside the Gates with a left-handed hook. Rebound to number 32, Wisniewski. Rockets in man-to-man. Switch on the screen down low. Gates over with Owens. Owens misses. Rebound right to the pickers. Three-point basket by number 10, Trent Leonard, for the Pickers. 3-0 to start the ball game in favor of the Pickers. Rocket basketball moving around the outside. Kai Skinner with a three. Ties the ball game up. Real early in the first quarter, 7 minutes left to play. Skinner flies by Owens. Owens with a miss. Out to Leonard. Leonard to Owens. Rockets in their man-to-man. Pickers look inside to Mays. No good. It'll be Northeast basketball out of bounds underneath. Let's see if Northeast sets up much like the JVs did. Every out of bounds play they ran was a box set. They're in a 1-4 set. They're going to look outside, look for that post screen. Nothing there. Over to Owens. Blocked by Gates. Owens tips it out of bounds. It should be Rocket basketball. Nice drive by Owens that time, but Gates was right there to shut it down. Ciccarelli gets the offense started. Into Gates, backdoor cut by Corkland, nothing there. Skinner with the penetration, pulls up jumper, and a nice soft touch off the iron. Good touch that time by Kai Skinner. Leonard running the show for Northeast. Over to Mays. Mays into Owens. Owens with a turnaround jumper. A little cold right now. He's missed his first three shots of the game. Ciccarelli with a long one-handed pass to Corkland. Corkland still controlling the basketball. The Rockets out to Schneider. Over to Skinner. And we reset the offense. Northeast still in man-to-man. Looking for Gates inside. Nothing there. Skinner with a penetration. Loses control of the ball, bounces it off of Owens, and it'll be Rocket basketball. Right in front of the Northeast bench on the sideline. Rocket set up in an I with Corkland on the opposite sideline. Ciccarelli to inbounds the ball to Schneider. Schneider back to Ciccarelli. Gets a nice screen from Skinner. Schneider back to Ciccarelli. Calls for a screen from Corkland. Doesn't use it. Sends it over to Skinner. To Schneider in the corner. Off the iron. Gates with the rebound. And he's fouled. Fouled underneath. Foul is on number 32, Andrew Wisniewski. That's his first. That's the first foul of the ball game for the Pickers. Tyler Gates on the line shooting two. Let's see if we can get Tyler back on track with his free throws. He had a good night the other night at Fairview. Misses the first one. And the second one up and good. 6-3 Rockets, 5:20 remaining in the first quarter.
Hey, Rockets doing a good job not forcing anything tonight. They're just working the ball around.
They're very patient so far. Northeast looks like they're very, very athletic. Just my first opinion of them. Long shot by Mays. That is just barely grazed the backboard. Ciccarelli a little sloppy with the basketball. Fast break by Northeast, and that'll be good by number 10, Trent Leonard. Got to take better care of the basketball. Ciccarelli forced that jumper, just as you say, Luke, that we're not forcing anything. Skinner for three. Yes.
I'll just keep my mouth shut here on out.
Skinner moving up the 1,000-point list tonight. Those two three-pointers give him 1,028 points. The next one he will surpass will be Richie Dowling. And a three-point basket by Northeast and a very quick timeout by Coach Jason Keim. 9-8 with 4:24 remaining in the first quarter.
A lot of people name their trucks. Names like White Lightning, Bruiser, or Big Red.
At Community Chevrolet, we name our trucks too, such as Baja, Recon Tactical, Black Ops, Black Ops Elite. Stop into Community Chevrolet and check out the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size pickup on the road today. The customized Silverado produced by Tuscany Trucks. Only at Community Chevrolet.
Find new roads in a Tuscany truck to Community Chevrolet on the Conia Lake Road, just west of I-79 in Meadville.
And back with the Rockets up 9-8 in this first quarter of play.
Nice crowd here tonight. The student section is out in full force to support the Rockets. Rockets come into tonight's game in first place in Region 4 with an 8-1 record, followed by Northwest a half point or half game behind at 8-2 and Fairview at 7-2.
Very competitive, this league.
This region is very, very competitive, Luke. I would have to agree with you. Corklin running the show this time. Three-point shot by Corklin, no good. Rebound to Wisniewski for Northeast. Leonard with the ball over to Kitchen. Kitchen picks up his dribble. Nice backdoor cut by Mays, but he's met there by Tyler Gates. Schneider ahead to Skinner. Skinner pulls up for a jumper on a baseline, and he's fouled in the act of shooting. That foul is going to be on number 10, Trent Leonard. That's the second team foul for Northeast, the first on Leonard. Kai Skinner will be at the line for two. Rockets really got the ball quickly down the floor on that fast break. I like how they get it down there as quickly as possible and put the pressure on that Northeast defense. First one's no good for Skinner. So a little bit of a shaky start from the free throw line tonight as compared to how well we shot free throws at Fairview on Wednesday.
Free throws ended up being a big part of the JV win tonight.
Yeah, they were right at the tail end there. We saw Cade Skinner make a few. There's a nice steal by Ciccarelli. He's looking up the floor. Looks up, sees nothing, keeps it for himself. Penetrates into the lane to Corklin. Corklin surveys the landscape, nothing there. The Rockets restart. Skinner on the wing. Back out to Ciccarelli. Not much movement right now on the Rockets offense. There's a screen by Gates for Skinner. He kicks it over to Ciccarelli. His three-pointer is a little bit off. Rebound to Kitchen. Kitchen tries to take it all the way in, stops, gives it off to... That was Trent Leonard with the basketball. He missed that shot. Skinner. Rockets are having a little trouble handling the basketball tonight. Maybe it's a situation where there's too much air in the basketball instead of the deflate gate that we've been through in the football. We've got another foul on number 10, Trent Leonard. That will be his second, team third, and Kai Skinner is going to go to the line. Skinner at the line for two. He's got the hat trick right now. We've got to get this next one, and I'm sure he's going to make this next one. 0-for-3 so far. Into the game for the Rockets, Zach Richards, senior Richards, in for the Dan Schneider. Substitution in for Northeast, number 23, Brock Kahn. He was the point guard for the JV team, so he's getting a lot of early time here tonight in a varsity game. Second one's good for Skinner, just like we called. Kahn running the show. Over to Mays. Mays to Kitchen. Kitchen to Wisniewski. Wisniewski for a long three, and that's good. Left him open, gave him plenty of time to shoot it, and the Pickers take the lead, 11-10. Rocket cheering section, calling for a little bit better offense this time. Kirkland drives into the lane, puts up the jumper, no good. And a rebound to Mays. Mays looks up the floor. Over to Owens. Owens to Kitchen. Kitchen with the long three-pointer, no good. Gates with the rebound, outlet to Corkland. Corkland to Richards. Richards takes the shot, no good. And we've got a rebound to Northeast and a foul on Tyler Gates. Gates with his first, that's a Rockets team first. 1:52 remaining in the first quarter, 11-10 Northeast.
Gates, one of the seniors recognized tonight.
The Rockets had five seniors tonight. We've got Nate Ciccarelli and Tyler Gates in the starting lineup. Zach Richards, first one off the bench. And then the other two seniors are Zach Edwards and Drew Baldwin. If you remember correctly, Baldwin was the crowd favorite the last game that we played here at home against Iroquois. Skinner with a pass ahead to Schneider. Schneider with another three-pointer. No good. The Rockets seem to be really wanting to push the ball, and they're shooting very quickly. I'm not sure that's what Coach Craig Mellerbacher wants, but it could be part of what their offensive strategy is. Owens with another miss. Blocked by Gates. That's a monster block right there, and he kept the ball in play. That's critical when you block a shot, is if you can keep it in play, then we could possibly get a fast break. Not so much that time. Ciccarelli with the ball. Ciccarelli over to Skinner. He drives the baseline, and that is a nice drive, baseline drive by Skinner. Kahn with the basketball. Pretty good defense that time by Dan Schneider. Owens behind the back dribble, loses Schneider, and he misses another one. Ciccarelli with the rebound. Owens tonight is a little bit off to this point. Right now he's in an offer. Richards looks inside the Gates. Not there. Back to Ciccarelli. Rockets with four out and one in offense. Schneider with the basketball. Looks to Richards. He loses the ball. Picked up by Kitchen. Kitchen pulls up to Mays. Mays with a baseline jumper. Pretty good defense that time by Ciccarelli. And the ball goes out of bounds off of Gates. Crowd's not happy with the call by the official. It'll be Northeast basketball underneath. And looks like the... Okay, the explanation was the officials conferred and they decided it was Titusville basketball. Long jumper to end the quarter by Kai Skinner's off the backboard, no good. The first quarter is in the books, 12-11 Titusville.
Meadville Medical Center and Titusville Area Hospital are now one, providing health care focused on you. High quality, close to home, affordable care, and compassion for our patients, surgical excellence, and innovative procedures. Your health, your community, care you trust. Meadville Medical Center and Titusville Area Hospital.
Correct, I have a life mate.
Is that consequential?
With whom are you communicating?
Jake from Planet State Farm.
Jake from Planet State Farm at 0300 hours. State your identity.
It is Jake from Planet State Farm, home of Discount Double Check.
Describe your apparel, Jake from Planet State Farm.
Khakis.
Khakis. Explain.
A dull earthly garment covering male extremities.
Sounds most appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
Save mass quantities, even at 0300 hours. Get to a better state.
And we have our khakis on tonight as we enjoy Rocket basketball. Start of the second quarter of play. Rockets up 12-11.
That was a good first quarter by Northeast. They seem to be, as I mentioned earlier, a very athletic team. This is the first that I've seen in this year. Trying to set up in a 1-4 set on offense, and we've got a 5-second call. Great job by Dan Schneider and the rest of the Rockets on the defensive end.
A few misfires offensively for the Rockets, Coach, but defensively doing very well.
Very well defensively against this Northeast team. I like what I see so far from both teams. I'd like to see us kick it in a little bit. There's a three-pointer by Schneider, and we've taken an awful lot of three-pointers tonight. I think if we just take our time, they'll start to fall. Nice drive that time by Kitchen. No good. Rebound to Wisniewski, and up and in. Northeast takes the lead by one. Ciccarelli calls out the play. Skinner comes off a double screen set by Corklin and Schneider. Schneider, another three-pointer. No good. Rebound to Owens. Owens up to Kitchen. Kitchen with a three-pointer. No good. And Gates with the rebound. I don't think either team has realized that they have some big guys that can shoot the ball inside tonight. Seems to be we just want to shoot from the outside for both teams. It'll be Rocket basketball underneath. Gates into Skinner. He posts up inside. Skinner doesn't throw him the ball. It looks instead to Corklin. Corklin back to Skinner. Cross-court pass to Schneider. Schneider into Gates. Nice pass that time. Good bounce pass by Danny Schneider. Northeast coaches are calling for a travel, but it's not to be. Referee Bill Agnew just shakes his head as he goes by the bench. Owens. That's a foul on Corklin. That'll be Corklin's first. Team second for the Rockets.
Well, we've spent previous games talking about his experience, and certainly something that when you have a game like this, it's nice to see you have experience out there on the floor.
Well, I mean, I'm assuming you're talking about the referees.
Yes.
And yes, I would have to agree with you. We've got a charge on Northeast. That charge is on number 10, Trent Leonard. That's his third with only 6:15 to play in the second quarter. So one of their starters already in foul trouble for this game. That brings Brock Kahn back into the game. He had just sat down. Corklin looks inside the Gates. Great pass by Corklin. Good move by Tyler Gates. Rockets take a three-point lead. 6 minutes to play. There's a foul on Ciccarelli. A little bit out of control. It'll be Northeast basketball on the side.
We're talking to assistant coach Skinner during the junior varsity game, Coach, and he was saying that they racked up 20 points in that or 20 fouls in that first half.
The JVs did.
The JVs, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it was a foul fest for a while there. It sure was. We've got Kitchen with the basketball over to Wisniewski. Wisniewski to Mays. Mays drives baseline, and nobody there to pick up the baseline drive, and it's a good left-handed layup by Mays. 1 point difference in the game. Rockets with the lead. Corklin. Rockets are being very patient. Corklin penetrates. Nothing. Over to Schneider. Schneider cross-court pass to Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli with a cross-court pass back to Schneider. Schneider off the move. I've said earlier that I don't think that that's his shot off the move. He's more of a standstill three-point shooter. Corklin fouled that time by number 21, Garrett Owens, and good sportsmanship that time by Owens. Knocked Corklin to the floor and reached right down to help him up. Substitution in for Northeast.
He did get points for the takedown, right?
2 points for the takedown, right. August Neff, number 22, is in the game for Kahn. Rockets out of bounds underneath to Skinner. Skinner looks out to Schneider. Ciccarelli takes a look inside. Screen coming from Gates. Ciccarelli uses the screen, pulls up for the jumper, and it's good. Nice shot that time by the senior, Ciccarelli. Mays with the basketball to Owens. Owens inside to Kitchen. Nice follow by Wisniewski. Rebound to Neff. He kicks it out to Mays. Mays with a drive, another left-handed layup. He throws the ball off of Tyler Gates and into the student section. It will be Northeast basketball, and another great show of sportsmanship by Northeast. Really like to see that, Luke.
It was nice that the seniors on the Northeast team were also recognized tonight.
Well, you know, I think that's a very classy move by the Titusville Rockets. Not the first time that I've seen that. As a matter of fact, the first time I ever saw it was about 3 years ago at Iroquois, and I'm pretty sure that's where we got the idea. Hmm. It's a really classy move, and I have to give Iroquois a lot of credit for doing something like that. I was really shocked when I saw it up there. Tough pass that time to handle from Cade Skinner. Cade in the game. Here comes Corklin back in the game for Schneider. So right now the Rockets have Corklin, Ciccarelli, Gates, and the Skinner brothers on the floor. Mays with the basketball for Northeast. Over to Kitchen, back to Mays. Cross court to Owens. Back to Kitchen. Kitchen with a tough pass into Owens. Looked like a foul on Gates, but the referees didn't call it. Nice shot that time by Owens.
Now back within one.
Skinner, another, Cade Skinner, another tough pass into Gates. I know we want to get it inside, but we can't just throw it in there helter-skelter like we have the last couple times. Northeast takes the lead, 19-18, with 3.5 left in the first half. Skinner looks, fakes, nothing there. And it's out of bounds on the side. It'll be Rockets basketball right in front of our bench. Ciccarelli with the basketball. Looks inside to Gates. Gates double teamed. Nice pass over to Cade Skinner. I'm not sure he was expecting that. Rebound to Gates, and Gates is fouled. Foul is on 32. Andrew Wisniewski, the senior. That's his second. Team sixth. Tyler Gates at the line for two. First one, no good. Number 23, Brock Kahn, back into the game for Northeast. He's in for Kitchen. Gates with a second. Off the back of the iron, no good. Off of Brady Corklin, it'll be Northeast basketball. Kahn brings it up the backcourt, into the front court. To Wisniewski. Wisniewski looks over to Kahn. Kahn out to Owens. Owens fakes the jumper. Guarded by Kai Skinner. Wisniewski guarded by Gates. Neff to Owens. No good, but the Rockets didn't block out. Wisniewski with the ball over the top of Gates, off the front of the iron. No good. Corklin with a strong rebound. Kai Skinner knocked to the floor that time. No call by the officials. Ciccarelli all the way to the basket and good. I think Northeast was expecting that screen to be set by Tyler Gates, and Ciccarelli just split the defense and took it all the way himself. Kahn over to Mays. Mays looks inside to Owens. Nothing there. Being guarded by Kai Skinner. Over to Kahn. To Wisniewski. Guarded by Gates. And there's another long three-pointer by Wisniewski. I don't know. I think if I was Tyler Gates, I'd put a little bit more pressure on him. Corklin takes it all the way in. This is a rough and tumble game out here, and we're just going to play basketball tonight. Not too many fouls called. Owens with the ball, guarded by Kai Skinner. Wisniewski, let's see if Tyler Gates comes out. Yeah, a little bit more that time. Wisniewski's proven to me that if you give him time, he can make that three-pointer. Owens with the ball. A little bit disoriented that time, and so the Northeast coach would like a timeout with a score 22-20 Northeast.
I bought several trucks off of Joe here. Always got a good deal. He's very honest.
Joe's a nice guy. He's personable. Bought eight cars off him.
Joe's a great guy. His service department, they're fantastic. Sales department, they'll make sure it happens for you.
Joe Taylor Ford didn't disappoint me, that's for sure.
Come on out and get a good deal.
people here are totally amazing, and I got my new car.
Route 257
in Seneca.
Well, even from that angle, you can see the crowd is just here and ready to support their teams. Northeast bringing a few fans along with them.
There's a few here from Northeast, but the Rocket fans have spilled over into the Northeast section, so that's a good sign. It's nice to have the home crowd here. We've got about a minute and, I believe, 28 seconds left to play in the first half. Northeast has taken the lead. They've done a great job running their offense. Titusville seems to be a little bit helter-skelter on what we're doing, both offensively and then on the defensive boards. I think we need to pick things up just a little bit down there also. It'll be Northeast basketball in front of the parents section. Mays will be inbounding the ball. Mays to Kitchen, who's back in the game. Let's see what Northeast wants to do as we come down to the end. Oh, a nice backdoor cut that time by Mays. Good pass by Owens, but look out because the human eraser was in there, Tyler Gates. He blocks that shot out of bounds, and it'll be Northeast ball. Neff inbounding the ball. Ciccarelli with good defense, but Mays recovers the pass. Mays to Owens. Over to Mays. Mays. Oh, that looked like a double dribble. Owens with the basketball to Neff. Neff inside to Mays over the top of Skinner. No good. Tyler Gates with a strong rebound, and he falls to the floor. That'll be a travel. That's a good call that time by the officials. Very good call. It'll be Northeast ball, 51.2 seconds remaining in the half. Two-point lead for the Pickers. There's a box set this time by Northeast. Cross screen by Mays, and then they throw it all the way out to Mays at the timeline. Mays to Kitchen. Kitchen inside to Owens. Nobody guarding him. The Rockets didn't communicate that time if there was going to be a switch. Both guys went to Mays, and it's an easy bucket for Owens. Ciccarelli to Schneider. Rockets back to their starting lineup. 30 seconds remaining in the half. Ciccarelli off the Gates screen. Over the top. Gates up and in.
A beautiful pass into Gates.
Excellent pass that time. I like how we took our time. Got it inbounds there. 14 seconds remaining. A little confusion in front of us right here by Northeast. Kitchen with the ball. 8 seconds remaining. Kitchen guarded by Ciccarelli. He takes an off-balance jumper, and it goes in right before the buzzer. How that went in, I'll never know. 26-22, Northeast leads at the half.
Second half action coming up. Titusville Rocket basketball on stream television.
Since Congress chartered the American Legion in 1919, the Cleo J. Ross Post 368 has been a major part of the Titusville community. The Legion promotes patriotism, honor, and committed devotion to our fellow service members and veterans. We also sponsor various programs such as youth wrestling. We offer scholarship awards and benefit dinners to aid our local community. The American Legion Cleo J. Ross Post 368 is here to make a difference at 113 East Central Avenue, Titusville. Anderson Physical Therapy is committed to your long-term health and well-being. With certified, licensed therapists, Andersons can provide therapy for all your rehabilitation needs. With our new location in Titusville at 202 Union Street and our new offices at 118 Main Street, Titty Ute, Anderson makes it convenient for you to get back to doing the things you enjoy. So stay on top of your game with Anderson Physical Therapy. Now in 7 locations and online 24/7 at andersonphysicaltherapy.net.
Right now, this moment, the way you watch TV can change. And not in the, I liked it more before kind of way, but in the, how did I ever live without this kind of way. EXP blends Armstrong services, creating a new experience, recording 6 shows at once. Stream programs to watch anywhere. Search to find your favorite actor, show, or movie. Record shows from anywhere. And it can start today. This is EXP, and this changes everything.
Bayless Fuel sells only ultra-low sulfur home heating oil. No matter what energy you use to heat your home, heating oil offers some distinct advantages. It is environmentally sound, biodegradable, non-toxic, and non-carcinogenic. We also offer BioHeat to be even more environmentally conscious. With dependable delivery from Bayless Fuel, you will have the fuel you need to stay warm and comfortable when winter rears its ugly head. Bayless Fuel is proud to carry products that deliver the quality and performance you expect. Call 827-3336 or visit us at 202 South Brown Street in Titusville.
And welcome back to the Launchpad. Second half action just moments away. The Rockets trail to Northeast 26-22. Our coverage of Titusville Rocket basketball on stream television is brought to you by Bayless Fuel Service, by State Farm Insurance, by Oil Creek Plastics, by the Colonial Machine Company, by Donovan and Bauer Auto Group, by Anderson Physical Therapy, by Big G Tire and Auto, by the University of Pittsburgh at Titusville, by Joe Taylor Ford, by Armstrong, by the American Legion, by Community Chevrolet, by Warm Home and Hearth, and by Titusville Area Hospital. Again, second half action just moments away, and we are down 26-22. Coach, what needs to happen here in the second half?
Well, the first thing is that we cannot panic. We're in a situation here where we've been shooting the ball very quickly on offense, not necessarily trying to get the best shot that we can possibly get. And what's happening is as the half went along, Northeast started to do a little bit better job with their offense, and we missed a couple backdoor cuts. They started to get some offensive rebounds. We miscommunicated once on a screen and didn't switch it correctly. So we've got to do a little bit better job, but that all could be taken care of. It's a tough ball game here. Kai Skinner led the way the first half with 11 points, bringing him up to 1,033 points. He's just six short of Richie Dowling.
Wow.
To move into fifth place as the men's all-time or the men's 1,000-point list. For Northeast, Trent Leonard and Andrew Wisniewski led the pickers with 8 points apiece. Northeast is very much a senior-laden lineup. All five starters are seniors. And they're very, very, as I've said a couple times before, they're very, very athletic. I know that their former coach was well-schooled in man-to-man defense. Tommy Pyle was their coach for many years up there. And I see him sitting in a stands tonight in the audience. I don't know the new coach that's here, but it looks like they've kept up the tradition of good, tough man-to-man defense. And normally Northeast has some good three-point shooters also, and that's coming through tonight also.
All righty. Both teams coming out, getting ready to start the second half of play. Again, senior night here at the Launchpad. It is the last regular season game here in Titusville.
Yeah, that's correct. And the reason we say that it's the last regular season game is that District 10 has made some changes in the playoff structure this year. And there's a chance that if we get one of the top seeds, I'm not sure if it's the top two seeds or the top four seeds. I don't know for sure. But there's a good chance if things continue the Rockets' way that we could host a playoff game here at Titusville. So you don't want to say it's the last time that these seniors will set foot on this court for a game.
Yeah, and that possibility is very exciting.
For sure, Luke, for sure. It would be nice to see the Rockets do that. Here we are to start the second half.
Good job.
Defense that time by Northeast. Gates is getting the ball, but he's getting it out a little further than what he usually does. Northeast, Wisniewski is pushing him out a little bit. That was a nice pass by Tyler Gates into Kai Skinner. Foul on Northeast. That foul was on, well, there we go. It's on number 21, Garrett Owens, his second. Corklin with an air ball. Rebound to Mays. And Northeast starts in the second half with Brock Kahn running the point. As I said earlier, he is the JV point guard. Into Wisniewski. Backdoor cut by Mays, and he left Schneider just with his head on a swivel. Nice basket that time by Northeast. That was an excellent play. We've got to be able to see the man and see the ball if we're going to play defense against this team. Ciccarelli with a penetration out to Skinner. Skinner all the way to the hoop. Up, no good. Rebound to Wisniewski for Northeast. Kahn with the basketball. Over to Owens. Screen set inside for Wisniewski. Nothing there. Owens continues to dribble the basketball into Wisniewski. Up against Gates. Gates with the block. Out of bounds. Tyler left his feet there just for a second. A lot of times the offensive player will give a little pump fake and try to get the defender off his feet. Thankfully, Tyler did not draw a foul. Northeast ball into Mays. Mays with a baseline drive, reverse layup, and it's good. Northeast with their biggest lead of the game, 30-22, with 6.5 to play here in the third quarter. Ciccarelli with a three-pointer, and it's good, and we needed that one. Maybe that'll slow down the Northeast Tide and pick the Rockets up a little bit. 30-25, Pickers. Owens with the ball being guarded by Brady Corklin. He's calling for a screen. Tries to take it inside. Blocked by Gates. Rebound right back to Owens. Owens out to Kitchen. Kitchen is... And Northeast is called for 3 seconds. Well, I'll tell you, you don't see 3 seconds called hardly at all anymore.
I was just going to say that.
Matter of fact, I think the referees are told, if I were to guess, they're told, boy, if you're calling 3 seconds, you're never going to get a playoff game. I hesitated before I said what happened. I just couldn't believe it. Corklin with the miss. Mays with the rebound. Northeast is playing very, very well right now. Nobody guarding Mays. He pulls up, no good. Rockets seem to be a little bit confused on their defensive assignments here in this early in the second half. Ciccarelli to Schneider. Schneider again with a miss. Out to Ciccarelli. No good. And it'll be Northeast basketball.
Boy, we were talking about the shot he had the other night.
Oh, the one against...
Game winner.
The game winner against Fairview, and it was fun. I read the account in the Erie Times News where they interviewed Nate, and he talked about how he was not having a good game, but that's what you like to see. You know, just keep shooting away, keep shooting, and he picked the right time to make that jumper. There's an air ball by Owens right to Gates. Schneider with the basketball over to Ciccarelli. The Rockets have really forgotten about the inside game here. We don't seem to be getting Gates the basketball. That was an inadvertent pass by Skinner off the mark. Northeast with the ball, and they turn it over to Corklin. Corklin in for the layup, and oh, my goodness, there's a foul on number 23, Kahn. What happened? Corklin went up for the shot, and Kahn went head over heels right over the top of Corklin. It looks like he's okay. That's great. Glad to see that he's A-okay. We've got Trent Leonard going back in the game. He had 3 fouls, if you remember, early in the second quarter. He's coming back in the game for Northeast. Kahn seems to be okay. That's good to see.
Trent, you're the one dropping the two. You call that on the floor, sir. Sir, you waved it off.
Corklin misses, and I'll tell you, the Rockets are stone cold from the free throw line tonight. Corklin with his second. Another miss by the Rockets. Leonard with the basketball. To Wisniewski. Owens takes it all the way to the hoop. And there's a foul on the Rockets. Rocket foul this time is on number... Called it on... 21 for the Rockets, but I don't have a 21 for the Rockets. Owens with the miss. The foul was on Corklin. Referee corrects it. So number 20, Brady Corklin with a foul. That's a first team foul on the Rockets. Second one up and in. 6-point lead for the Pickers with 4:20 left to play in the third quarter. Ciccarelli with a nice drive into Gates. A nice little layup there. That's what we need. We've got to get the ball inside a little bit more. The more we, we've got to walk, and I'm yelling into the microphone here.
Oh, both of us. I tell you what, we've said this before, and Jim Bodimer and I talk about this all the time. We're such fans of the Titusville Rockets and of high school sports, it's hard not to be into the games.
I found that every game that I show up to help you out, that I get into it more and more. You just want the Rockets to win so badly. There's a nice power move by Tyler Gates. And just as we talked about getting the ball inside, we've done it two times in a row. The Rockets pull within two. 31-29, long jumper by Kitchen. Strong rebound. And we've got Wisniewski down on the floor. That foul is going to be on Garrett Owens for Northeast.
And I loved seeing that. You talked about it earlier. Gates was over there making sure he was okay.
Yes. Yep. Three fouls now on Owens. So we've got a couple players for Northeast that are in foul trouble. That's their third team foul. Corklin to Skinner. Skinner at the foul line. Looks inside, nothing there. There's Gates flashing into the lane. We had him. Didn't go for it. Rockets call out number five. Nice defense that time by Kitchen. But Ciccarelli finally goes past the bench for Northeast. Calls for a carry. They may have been correct on that one. Needless to say, it does not get called. It'll be Rockets basketball. Skinner blocked by Owens. Recovered by Ciccarelli. A nice little reverse layup. And we've got a tie ball game with 3:08 remaining in the third quarter. We've got a timeout. Northeast Grape Pickers. 3:04 remaining in the third period.
Since Congress chartered the American Legion in 1919, the Cleo J. Ross Post 368 has been a major part of the Titusville community. The Legion promotes patriotism, honor, and committed devotion to our fellow service members and veterans. We also sponsor various programs such as youth wrestling. We offer scholarship awards and benefit dinners to aid our local community. The American Legion Cleo J. Ross Post 368 is here to make a difference at 113 East Central Avenue, Titusville.
And welcome back to the Launchpad. Timeout called as Titusville ties things up 31 apiece. A very exciting ball game tonight.
Well, the Rockets have done a good job the last three times down the floor. All three times we've gotten the ball inside, twice to Tyler Gates, once to Nate Ciccarelli. We've shot the ball all within 5 feet of the basket, and that's pretty much what we're going to have to do to try to make to open up things on the outside for our three-point shooters. Rockets playing good, aggressive man-to-man defense right now. Schneider guarding Owens. Owens out to Mays. Over to Kitchen. Kitchen to Leonard. Leonard drives the baseline, and he's fouled, I think, by Nate Ciccarelli that time, and that's a good basket for an old-fashioned three-point play. Yeah, that foul's on Ciccarelli. I believe that's his first of the game. That's his second, check that. Second of the game, second team foul for the Rockets. Trent Leonard at the line for one to complete the old-fashioned three-point play.
Yeah, they're shooting well from the foul line.
They certainly are, and that's the difference in the ball game right now, is our free throw shooting has been, I hate to say it, but it's been horrendous. Skinner with the basketball over to Corklin. Corklin looks in, nothing there. Let's see if we can get it back inside again. Skinner gets a screen from Gates. Ooh, almost intercepted by Owens. Ciccarelli with a nice drive. Little bit helter-skelter. Rebound to Northeast. Bounce pass into Owens. Owens is fouled. That foul looked like it was on the pass. Referee called a two-shot foul that looked to me like it was on the pass. The foul is on Gates. The other referee overruled the call, and it will be out of bounds underneath for Northeast. That's Gates' second. Titusville's team third. Bounce pass to Wisniewski, and the Rockets were sleeping on the out-of-bounds play. Did not communicate again, and there's a five-point lead for Northeast. Kai Skinner with the basketball. Takes it down the baseline. Off the glass and in. Nice play by Skinner. Nice little 8 to 10 foot jumper off the glass. Northeast with the ball inside to Mays. Mays on the baseline. He stepped on the end line. It'll be Rockets basketball. 3-point lead for the Pickers. 1:34 remaining in third period. Rockets will inbound the ball in the backcourt. Kai Skinner with the ball, bringing it up the floor to the timeline. Sets the screen from Gates, does not use a screen. Ciccarelli with the ball, guarded tightly by Owens. Owens steals it from him. Nice pass. Oh, great fast break by Northeast. They couldn't come up with a rebound. And that'll be a foul on Wisniewski from Northeast. That's his third. We've got three players with three fouls for Northeast. Team fourth.
Sounds like Northeast coach isn't very happy.
Not real thrilled, no. But I've been in his shoes. I get it. Great defense that time by Northeast. They double teamed. They're getting really good weak side help. They're trying to get the ball into Tyler Gates, and the weak side help is outstanding. If we can get a shooter over in that corner, whoever Mays is guarding, Mays is, you know, he's guarding Schneider. Schneider's having a rough night from the floor, but he's going to be the open man. Sometimes you're open for a reason. I always told my players, you know, they would come off the floor and say, I'm open, I got to shoot. I said, well, there's a reason you're open. And the reason you're open is you're not making anything that night. That's a double dribble by Kai Skinner. Crowd reacts in a little bit of disgust. 37 seconds left in the period. Northeast with a 3-point lead. Call for one shot. Let's see if they can run the clock down or if the Rockets can play defense well enough to take the ball back and get a possession of their own. Wisniewski out to Owens. Owens looks to Kitchen. Kitchen with the basketball. Out at the logo. Leonard, 16 seconds. Leonard penetrates. Nothing there. To Kitchen. Out to Owens. 6 seconds remaining. Leonard tries to take it past Gates. Mays with a long jumper, and it's no good. 36-33, Northeast with the lead at the end of three.
Anderson Physical Therapy is committed to your long-term health and well-being. With certified, licensed therapists, Andersons can provide therapy for all your rehabilitation needs. With our new location in Titusville at 202 Union Street and our new offices at 118 Main Street, Titty Ute, Anderson makes it convenient for you to get back to doing the things you enjoy. So stay on top of your game with Anderson Physical Therapy. Now in 7 locations and online 24/7 at andersonphysicaltherapy.net.
Right now, this moment, the way you watch TV can change. And not in the, I liked it more before kind of way, but in the, how did I ever live without this kind of way? EXP blends Armstrong services, creating a new experience, recording 6 shows at once. Stream programs to watch anywhere. Search to find your favorite actor, show, or movie. Record shows from anywhere. And it can start today. This is EXP, and this changes everything.
And welcome back, 36-33, fourth quarter, final 8.
Well, Luke, Northeast comes into this ballgame tonight with an overall record of 6-13. They're 3-6 in Region 4. They have every reason, with just a few games left in the season, to just roll over and play dead. And they are just giving the Rockets everything that the Rockets can handle.
And we heard that these guys are very athletic. A lot of talented players on this team.
Very much so, very much so. They are working extremely hard. There's a great block by Gates from behind on Owens. Out of bounds. Picker basketball. Leonard will inbounds the ball. 1-4 set for Northeast. Throws it off of Ciccarelli's foot, and it'll remain Northeast ball. Same spot. Another 1-4 set. They look outside. We got a diagonal screen inside. Kitchen with the penetration to Wisniewski. Wisniewski looks at Leonard cutting down the lane. Nothing there.
Owens out to the top. There's Wisniewski again with that long jumper. No good. Ciccarelli with the rebound. Ciccarelli over to Schneider. Wide open. Another miss. Schneider's having a rough night tonight. Three-point shot by Leonard. Rebound in Northeast. Nothing there. Skinner over to Schneider. He misses the layup. Rebound to Northeast. Mays with the basketball. Mays over to Wisniewski. Back cut. Nothing there. And we've got an offensive foul on Owens. Skinner with great defense that time. And that's an offensive foul, and I believe that is the fourth foul on Owens. I'm correct. Five team fouls for Northeast. Rockets down three, 6:32 remaining in the ballgame. Ciccarelli waves Schneider over into the corner. We've got a 1-4 set for the Rockets. Gates off of a nice screen from Skinner, and he misses the left-handed layup. Nice offense that time by the Rockets. That was outstanding. Just couldn't follow through at the tail end of things. Great defense by Schneider. Schneider one on two. He needs to hold it up and gets a little impatient. Good defense, though, good hustle, I should say. And it'll be Rockets basketball in front of the student section. Maybe Nate Ciccarelli will inbounds the ball. Yes, Luke.
Yeah, I was going to say, maybe a little frustration there from the Pickers.
Yeah, they thought they should have had the call down there. Another three-point shot by Ciccarelli. Northeast with the rebound. Wide open is Leonard underneath. Out to Wisniewski. Into Owens, and this time the foul is on Ciccarelli. Owens with the bucket. Ciccarelli's going to have to keep his head. Got a little upset with the foul. I don't blame him. You know, it was a good call, but he got to keep his head. We had a timeout by the Titusville Rockets. 38-33 Northeast with 5:48 to play.
Bayless Fuel sells only ultra-low sulfur home heating oil. No matter what energy you use to heat your home, heating oil offers some distinct advantages. It is environmentally sound, biodegradable, non-toxic, and non-carcinogenic. We also offer BioHeat to be even more environmentally conscious. With dependable delivery from Bayless Fuel, you will have the fuel you need to stay warm and comfortable when winter rears its ugly head. Bayless Fuel is proud to carry products that deliver the quality and performance you expect. Call 827-3336 or visit us at 202 South Brown Street in Titusville.
And you can watch this game anytime you like, and the many other games we have and other programming, and on our YouTube channel. Visit us at streamnewsnow.com and click the YouTube link. Check out our channel. Over 4,000 hours worth of programming on there.
Wow, Luke. You're a busy guy.
I sleep through most of it.
Well, we've got a five-point game right now with Northeast in the lead. And I have to say, Luke, I am perplexed at how this Northeast team is 6-13 overall. I just don't see it. They have played extremely hard tonight. They've played extremely well. They've hustled after every loose basketball. And they are making the Rockets work for everything that they get. We've got Owens on the line for the back end of the three-point play, and that's good. Neff into the ball game to give Owens a break. Owens with four fouls.
Well, you said it earlier. They have nothing to lose, and that makes them a dangerous team to play.
Yeah, very much so. I would have to agree with you. Ciccarelli brings the ball up the floor. Rockets are running their five play. Over to Corklin. Corklin looks inside to Gates. And throws the ball out of bounds at half court. A little sloppy play by the Rockets. Rockets look a little flustered right now. Still plenty of time left in this game. Plenty of time. No reason to panic now. Just going to have to dig down deep. Leonard with the ball. To Mays in the corner. Mays cross court to Neff. And that's who we want shooting the basketball. That would be the seventh man for Northeast. He shoots an air ball, and it'll be Rockets basketball. Zach Richards into the ball game for Corklin. Ciccarelli. We're going to run number two this time. Skinner off of a little rub screen off of Gates, then gets another screen off of Gates. A three-pointer for Kai Skinner, and we needed that badly. Leonard over to Neff. Neff to Mays in the corner, being guarded by Richards. Ciccarelli out here with Leonard. Switch that time. We didn't communicate again. Rebound to Gates. He's having a great night on the boards. Richards with the basketball. Not sure we want him shooting this shot. That's not the offense that Coach Craig Mellenbacher wanted. I can pretty much tell you that for sure. Zach Richards is a great standstill shooter, but off the move, he still needs a little bit of work. Ball over to Mays in the corner. I think that's a walk, folks, and the referee agrees with me. Tried to step back behind that three-point line and forgot to put the ball on the floor first to do so.
I'm glad that talk you had with him prior to the game, you know, helped out. Hey, check with me before you make a call.
Well, I talked to all the officials before the game because I know most of them, and they're good guys. I tell you what, you have to give them a lot of credit. They put in a lot of hours, and they're always 50% wrong, no matter what happens. They're always wrong, according to half the crowd. Of course, tonight, if it goes against the Rockets, they're 75% wrong. Skinner to Ciccarelli. Little slip screen by Gates. Ciccarelli to Schneider. Schneider with another three-pointer. And yes! Oh, good for Danny Schneider. I'll tell you what. He has really struggled tonight, and he needed that one. Tied ball game with 3:44 to play. 39-39. Mays with the ball for Northeast, being guarded by Zach Richards. Out to Wisniewski. Let's make sure we don't leave him too far open. Wisniewski. Over to Leonard. Leonard posting up by Mays. Mays, little jumper. Rebound to Gates. Ciccarelli with a long pass to Skinner. Skinner with the drive. And we've got a foul on number four, Nathan Mays. And they're going to give him two shots for that. And I tell you what, I'm pretty sure this is a high school game, not an NBA game. We don't really have continuation in a high school game. That one really surprised me. We'll take it, though. Skinner at the line. And the woes from the free throw line continue.
Coach, you know, I'm in here biting my nails, but we know that these Titusville Rockets have been in very stressful games. They just came from one Wednesday that went into overtime. So they can do it.
They can do it. And those types of games will serve them well in the long haul. They're going to make the playoffs. There's no doubt of that. They want to win the region title. That's what's on their mind. Great steal by Ciccarelli. He's all the way in. He slips. He still was able to get the basket. Titusville in the lead, 42-39. 2:52 remaining in the game. Oh, what a great play by Ciccarelli that time. You've got to give him credit. I know Coach loves to see good defense but like that. Wisniewski trying to take it to Gates. Gates with a monster block. Take that stuff out of there. It's no good here at the launch pad, Northeast. Northeast ball underneath. Leonard will inbounds the ball, and we've got a timeout. Northeast, 2:41 remaining in the game. Rockets up by three.
Big G Tire and Auto on the Hightown Road in Titusville is your home to the largest selection of tires for small compact cars to large semis. Need an oil change, inspection, or repair? Big G can service your vehicle while it's in the shop. Protect your vehicle with our fluid film undercoating to keep the rust at bay. Big G will keep you on the road.
Tires for any size vehicle and auto repair. Come see us at Big G Tire and Auto on Hightown Road in Titusville.
And listen to the roar of the crowd here at the launch pad tonight as Titusville takes the lead after a long time, 42-39.
Well, it's been about halfway through the second period since we've had the lead. And I'll tell you, if you're going to replay anything, your news broadcast and sports broadcast on Monday morning, that steal by Ciccarelli, that was a game changer right there.
certainly the momentum changed, and we have the lead 42-39. Coach, still a lot of time left in this game.
Plenty of time. There's no resting right now. We've got to stay fired up. We've got to keep working hard. That three-point jumper by Schneider after such a rough game he's had shooting the basketball. He's continued to play really good defense, though. Owens, baseline drive. He meets with Gates. Gates blocks it. Who's going to get the ball? It'll be out to Owens. Owens to Kitchen. Kitchen with a long jumper by Wisniewski. No good. Rebound to Leonard. Leonard out to Kitchen. He throws a lob pass into Owens. Owens being guarded by Skinner off of Gates. I'll bet you Gates has close to 10 blocks tonight. He has just been a monster inside that lane. But to Northeast credit, they just keep right on plugging away. They're not going to back off. 5 second call for the Rockets. There's outstanding defense again. That's the second 5 second call we've gotten tonight. And it'll be Rockets ball. 2:19 left to play.
And add the 3 seconds into the paint defensively, Coach. These guys are playing well tonight.
A little bit of everything happening tonight. Corklin to Schneider. Schneider to Skinner. Skinner being guarded closely by Owens. Misses the layup. Owens with the ball. Over to Kitchen. Kitchen, cross-court pass to Mays, being guarded by Schneider. Baseline drive. He's cut off by Schneider. 1:48 remaining in the game. Leonard looks inside to Owens. Nothing there. Mays with the ball out by the logo. Over to Leonard. Leonard inside to Owens. Owens guarded by Skinner. Backdoor cut by Mays, and he lost Schneider again. We just don't seem to be able to see the man see the ball. 42-41, 1 point lead by the Rockets. Ciccarelli with the drive and misses the layup. It will be Rockets basketball. 1:16 left to play. 1 point lead for the Rockets. Box setup for the Rockets. Couple of screens into the backcourt for Corklin. Corklin over the timeline. And it'll be a timeout for Coach Craig Mellenbacher with 1:12 remaining in the game. The Rockets with a slim 1 point lead.
It's February, Groundhog's Day, Valentine's Day, and President's Day. To celebrate, we have the great President's Day sale.
On this Bighorn truck, stock number R039, take $10,000 off the sticker.
Take this Chrysler Town & Country and get up to $4,500 in rebates.
I am here today to accept the nomination of my party, not the donkeys or the elephants, but of the Ram Party for President of these United States. We will have Ronnie Care. Call me the Ronald.
That's a fantastic sound to hear.
It's a great sound, hopefully not premature. But the students have been outstanding tonight with the cheerleaders and the parents all together really supporting the Rockets. The students organized what looks to be a blackout tonight. They had a whiteout at the last game. A lot of black shirts, a lot of black face paint under the eyes tonight. So a great turnout to support their Titusville Rockets. And with 1:12 left in the game, the Rockets are with their starting lineup on the court. Ciccarelli, Skinner, Schneider, Corklin, and Gates for Northwestern. They're back to their starting lineup of Mays, Leonard, Owens, Wisniewski, and Kitchen. Corklin inbounds the ball to Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli takes a three-point shot almost with immediately after inbounding the ball. I'm not sure that's what what Coach Mellenbacher wanted, but he was open, so you can't fault him for taking that shot. Northeast with the ball, Mays. Over to Leonard with a three-point basket, a one-handed push shot like you used to see in the old days. Never left his feet, and that thing rattles in. The one guy that you think you can leave open, and boom, he makes it. Ciccarelli with a baseline jumper. No good. It'll be Rockets basketball. Down two, 32.4 seconds left.
Well, we saw one game tonight going to overtime.
Well, we'll see what happens here. Ciccarelli with the inbounds to Skinner. Skinner is fouled.
It'll be a two-shot foul. Foul on Northeast. It is on number 32, Wisniewski. Team seventh for Northeast. That's Wisniewski's fourth. 30 seconds remaining on the clock. Skinner will be at the line for two. First one. NBN, nothing but nylon. The all-important second one coming up. And it's good also. Never a doubt on those two. Tie ball game, 44-44. Northeast with the ball, 25 seconds left. And Northeast wants a timeout. 24.5 remaining, all tied up.
And we'll keep it right here. I'm just noticing, Coach, that the adult section, they're into it, but it's almost very cautious-like.
A lot of restless people over there, aren't there? I think anxious. Anxious might be the better word.
Well, I think it was the sweetheart dinner tonight, all that spaghetti just sitting at in the bottom of their stomachs.
Right now it's churning. All that the spaghetti and the salad and the drinks that they had, I'm sure that we've got a lot of churning stomachs, a lot of fast-beating hearts. Right now, I think I'm one of them. So let's see what we have here in these last few seconds of the ball game. It'll be Northeast basketball. It would not surprise me at all to see them work for the last shot. Here they are on the road. I'm sure they don't want Titusville to have the ball back again in this tie ball game. The foul situation, Titusville's got fouls to give, should they so choose to do so. They have 14 fouls, so they've got a couple to give if they would like to as time winds down. Northeast is in the bonus, so the Rockets would be shooting. 24.5 seconds remaining. Mays will inbound the ball for the Pickers. Mays to Leonard. Leonard takes his time over the timeline to Mays. Looks like they're trying to get it to Owens. Mays waves Owens back. Leonard being guarded by Ciccarelli. 10 seconds left. Ciccarelli with the reach. And we got a 5-second call. Ciccarelli closely guards Leonard, and we've got a 5-second call. That will be the third 5-second call based on the good defense that the Rockets have played tonight. That time, Nate Ciccarelli. And the Rockets are going to have the ball back with 5.7 seconds remaining in the game.
Again, a little frustration from the Pickers coach. I think he was looking for a reach.
Well, I think the reason that they were upset by that call, it wasn't that it was the wrong call. It's because the official who was right on top of the play did not make the call. It was the official who was off the play who made the 5-second call. And to be quite honest with you, I don't know whose call that is. It just doesn't look right when the referee right in front of the play doesn't call it. So we've got the cheerleaders that are getting the fans fired up. We've got the fans the whole student section is up right now. Rockets ball, they've got to go three quarters court with 5.7 seconds left. And there's a lot of complaining by the Northeast bench as the referees walk past the bench. Corklin will inbounds the ball. Rockets in a box set. Let's make sure, number one, let's get the ball inbounds first. There's plenty of time here. Ciccarelli with the ball. Ciccarelli fumbles it. He recovers it long. And it's off one of the other baskets that are used for the side baskets. And we are going to our second overtime tonight, Luke, 44-44. There'll be a 4-minute overtime here. Rockets didn't quite get a shot off that time. It was good defense on the part of Northeast. I know that they're a little upset by that 5-second call at the end of play, but it's a new ball game right now. And what a game we've had so far. Just what a game.
Absolutely. In overtime, what's working for the Rockets right now? What's in their favor?
Well, we've got to keep, I've said this over and over, we've got to get the ball inside.
Yeah, it's nice to have some good three-point shooters, but when you've got a 6'5 kid that towers over everybody, we've got to try to take advantage of that. The other thing that I think we need to do is we have to do a better job defensively on the backdoor cuts. We've had numerous backdoor cuts where we've lost sight of the man, lost sight of the ball. You know, we get caught looking at the basketball, and the Northeast player goes backdoor. And in particular, it's been Nathan Mays. He's the one that's really hurt us on those backdoor cuts.
Yeah, that baseline's been his friend tonight.
It certainly has. So we'll have a jump ball to start the overtime period. Starting lineups for both teams. We got foul trouble for Northeast. The Rockets have only four team fouls. So those next two will still be common fouls. Northeast has seven, so Titusville will be at the line for the remainder of the game. Gates controls the tip. Ciccarelli ahead to Skinner. Skinner penetrates all the way into Ciccarelli. Looks inside. There we go. Inside to Gates. Gates is fouled. That's what I'm talking about right there. That's a nice play that time by the Rockets. That foul is on number 32, Andrew Wisniewski. That will be his fifth. Team eight for Northeast. So Wisniewski will be out of the game. And he's been the main man guarding Tyler Gates. Let's see if we're intelligent enough that we're going to keep putting the ball inside to Tyler for the rest of this overtime. Into the game for the Pickers for the first time tonight. Alex Furmanek into the ball game for Wisniewski. Furmanek. Gates at the line. Two shots. First one. Off the back. Off the backboard, off the front, and no good. Touched everything up there except for the bottom of the net. Tyler with the second. And that one's no good. And should the Rockets lose this game tonight, they have nothing to look back on except for missed free throw opportunities. We have been, to put it bluntly, horrendous from the line. Owens. Out to Kitchen. Kitchen to Mays. Mays being guarded by Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli gets screened by Owens. Mays with his jump back. Shot, no good. Rebound to Leonard. Leonard, no good. Leonard again. Gates with the rebound. He's strong with that basketball. Rockets control the ball. 3:08 remaining. Skinner over to Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli looks into Gates. He's being fouled. Foul on number 50, Furmanek. Gates will go to the line for 1-1. That's Furmanek's first foul. Team ninth. 1-1 for Gates. Now we're talking. Nothing but the bottom of the net that time. Attaboy, Tyler. Gates with the second. Short, way short. Short arm that one. Northeast, Owens with the ball. Owens guarded by Skinner. Running a little pass and cut. They're popping out to the wing and then cutting back door. Shot that time by Kitchen. A two-pointer. Rocket ball, down one, 2:39 left to play. Schneider. With a long three-pointer. And after such struggles throughout the game, Danny Schneider, Kansas, second in a row, second three for Schneider, and the Rockets take a two-point lead. 2:22 left in the ball game. Owens for Northeast. Drives on Skinner, nothing. Over in the corner to Furmanek. Furmanek. Schneider with the rebound and fumbles it out of bounds. It'll be Northeast ball. Well, the one guy that hasn't played the whole game comes off and tries to shoot a three. I'm not quite sure about that one. Northeast with the ball to Furmanek. Furmanek into the inbounder. Owens. And we've got a foul on Furmanek. That'll be his second. Gates will go to the line again. The Rockets with a two-point lead with just under 2 minutes to play. This Rockets are in the double bonus right now. Two shots for Tyler Gates. Rockets have really worked hard this second half to cut into the Northeast lead. They've taken the lead a couple times. Gates, first one, short again. It's heartbreaking for these kids when they just struggle. It starts to get into your head. Gates with the second one, yes. 3-point lead for the Rockets. 1:57 on the clock. Owens with the ball. Owens drives all the way in. And we've got a foul on Skinner. Blocking foul on Skinner. Owens will go to the line. Owens a little gimpy on that play. I know he and Skinner are pretty good friends. He's trying to walk it off. Owens at the line for two. That's the fifth team foul on the Rockets. Boy, Owens is in some pain here. He's just been walking in circles between the foul line and the half court line, just back and forth, back and forth. But now he's ready to go. He wants that basketball. 1:50 left to play. Two shots for Owens. First one, no good. Gets a little support from his teammates. Rockets need to block out on this free throw. Owens for the second shot. It's good. 2-point lead for the Rockets. Full court pressure by Northeast. Skinner will bring the ball up, being guarded by Owens. Rockets are clearing out. Nothing there for Skinner. Skinner to Corklin. 2-point lead for the Rockets. Corklin down into the lane. Out, back out to Skinner. And Coach Mellebacher calls for a spread offense. Rockets are in the old North Carolina four corners offense. Skinner still with the basketball, takes it all the way down the lane, and good! 51-47, 1:09 left to play. Owens with the basketball. Owens drives against Skinner, and there's Gates again with the reject. We've got a timeout, full timeout for Northeast. 51-47 Rockets, 58.7 seconds remaining in the game.
It takes a lot for a community to be successful. Hard work, sacrifice, and the ability to take risks and go beyond your reach. This is nothing new for the residents here in small town USA, and it's certainly not new to the hundreds of student athletes who give their all on every level of play. From beginners to varsity to college and beyond, know that the Colonial Machine Company in Pleasantville is right behind you, supporting you all the way. Best of luck on the field and in life, the Colonial Machine Company.
A lot of people name their trucks. Names like White Lightning, Bruiser, or Big Red.
At Community Chevrolet, we name our trucks too, such as Baja, Recon Tactical, Black Ops, Black Ops Elite. Stop into Community Chevrolet and check out the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size pickup on the road today. The customized Silverado produced by Tuscany Trucks. Only at Community Chevrolet.
Find new roads in a Tuscany truck to Community Chevrolet on the Conia Lake Road, just west of I-79 in Meadville.
An overtime lead, 51-47 for our Titusville Rockets as they make their way back out on the floor.
Well, say what you want, Luke. The fans here tonight have gotten their money's worth. That is for sure. It's going to be Northeast basketball underneath their own hoop. They're in a box set. Screen across for Owens. Owens being guarded this time by Corklin. They set up a double screen for Mays. Mays with a long three-pointer. That thing goes all the way down the hoop and back out. And we've got a foul on Northeast by number 50, Furmanak. And Furmanak, a late entry into the game due to the disqualification of Wisniewski fouling out. And we're going to have Gates back on the line. Gates on the line. It'll be a two-shot foul. We're in the double bonus. Attaboy, Tyler. The first one finds the bottom of the net. 5-point lead for the Rockets. Let's make this one and make it a two-possession ball game. Gates with the second one up. And, oh, that one was another one of those that just kind of rattles around and falls out. Oh, a couple of, I think we're going to see what the, what's called here. A couple of screens set that time. There were hard screens by Northeast. Foul is on Ciccarelli as he fought through that screen. Nate's got to keep himself under control. Got to keep himself under control. He's talking with the official, but doing so very respectfully. He's the attaboy, Nate. Good job. Mays with the inbounds. Into Furmanek. He's looking for the back door by Owens. Owens blocked by Gates. Oh, and it's going to be Rocket basketball. That ball went off of Gates, off of Owens, right in front of the official, and the Rockets will have the ball with 40.4 seconds left. Coach Mellebacher is going to take a 30-second timeout with the Rockets up five.
And we'll stay right here.
Woo! What a ball game, Luke.
You doing okay, Coach?
I'm hanging in there. guy at my advanced age, I can handle it.
It's going to take me a month to grow these nails back.
Oh, no problem. That's why I keep mine nice and short. So the Rockets have the ball with a 5-point lead and 40-some seconds. I don't remember exactly how many seconds left, but 40-some seconds left. We need to hold on to the basketball. We do not. I'm going to repeat that. We do not need to shoot the basketball. We need to make our free throws when they foul us. We need to take care of the basketball, make sure we don't turn it over. And if we can do those two things, then the ball game's ours.
Coach, we're saying goodbye to seniors here tonight. And how memorable has this season been for them? And how memorable is this game going to be for them?
Well, these are the types of games that they're always going to remember. Danny Schneider, I can't say it any other way. He had a horrendous shooting night early on in the game. He made two great threes to keep us in the ball game, to bring us up into a tie. And he's going to remember this game. Skinner is fouled. Fouled by number 10, Leonard. Skinner goes to the line for two. 33 seconds remaining. Provided that the Rockets don't do anything foolish, things are looking really good for us at this time. I find it interesting. I've been watching throughout the game. I'm guessing that the Rockets know some of these kids from the Northeast team, because when the free throws are being shot, they're talking, they're just having conversations. You don't often see that.
No, there's a lot of respect,
that's
think.
Nice. I mean, we see that a lot in golf, but we certainly don't see it in basketball. Both shots good by Skinner. 7-point lead for the Rockets. Just play good defense. No need to foul. Just go ahead and let's play good defense. There's a wild shot by Northeast. Rebound to Gates. Gates makes a wild pass over to Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli did a great job getting possession of that. Picked the ball up, Nate. And we have got a... What do we have here? We've got a timeout by the Rockets. Timeout by the Rockets. And the Northeast coaching staff is livid over that call. They thought it should have been a jump ball.
Well, you can certainly feel the frustration. And again, not to say, we're excited by the Rockets, but again, Coach, you brought it up. The Pickers came in here tonight wanting that win, and they have played hard and they have played well tonight.
Oh, they have been outstanding. You have got to give Coach Jason Keim and his crew a lot of credit. They came in here tonight, as I stated earlier, with a poor record, really struggling on the year. But they've got a lot of good athletes. They play with a lot of heart, but so do our Titusville Rockets. And the Rockets have been able to pull away finally here in overtime as we wind the clock down. It'll be Rockets basketball at the half-court line in front of the parent section. A couple substitutions for Northeast. I'm just wondering if maybe we're going to see the old Hack-a-Shack. And see a lot of fouling in this last 14 seconds. Probably not with only 14 seconds remaining. Probably not. It's just time to call off the dogs. And as soon as I say that, I'm wrong. Mays with a foul immediately. And so we're going to go offense, defense, substitutions for Northeast. Only 1 second off the clock. That was a good job by Northeast. The bad news for them is Kai Skinner's at the line. And he... canned the last two. two shots for Skinner. First one's good. 55-47, 8-point lead.
Which and happened, folks, to be the difference from the last time these guys played.
Here's the human victory cigar. Baldwin, Aaron Baldwin into the game. Zach Edwards into the game. And we've got our seniors. Everybody's gotten a little PT, even if it's only just for a few seconds. A lot of people say, oh, what's the sense of putting them in? Well, it's senior night. You want to get these kids some playing time. And I understand sometimes some coaches will start all their seniors. But this was a really important game. It's something that we couldn't take lightly, as has been proven out here. So it's good to see both those guys in the game. Les, second heaves by Northeast. They're still hustling in as they try to do that. We've got an intentional foul being called on Owens that time. He was just trying to foul is all he was doing. There was nothing malicious about that particular foul. But it's going to be an intentional foul called on Owens. That will be his fifth personal foul. He will be out of the game. Gates will be at the line for two. Neff will join the pickers on the floor. Again, dissatisfaction being shown by the Northeast coaching staff. Referees trying to do a good job and have done a good job of handling this game. This is a game that could have easily gotten out of hand, and they've done an excellent job. A little showboating there by Gates. Not sure that we need that to end the game. Just this person's opinion is all. And the Rockets are going to close this game out with a win on senior night. An outstanding overtime win, 58-47, keeping the Rockets in first place in Region 4. A very happy group of Titusville Rockets. A huge crowd on hand, all going home, enjoying this Rockets win.
We'll take our final timeout, come back, and wrap things up here from the launch pad. Final 58-47.
Meadville Medical Center and Titusville Area Hospital are now one, providing healthcare focused on you. High quality, close to home. Affordable care and compassion for our patients. Surgical excellence and innovative procedures. Your health, your community, care you trust. Meadville Medical Center and Titusville Area Hospital.
Correct, I have a life mate.
Is that consequential?
With whom are you communicating?
Jake from Planet State Farm.
Jake from Planet State Farm at 0300 hours. State your identity.
It is Jake from Planet State Farm, home of Discount Double Check.
Describe your apparel, Jake from Planet State Farm.
Khakis.
Khakis. Explain.
A dull earthly garment covering male extremities.
Sounds most appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
Save mass quantities, even at 0300 hours. Get to a better state.
This is John Peterson from Warm Home and Hearth in Pleasantville. With 60-degree days and 40-degree nights, we all know what's coming soon. To assist you in your preparation for the cold weather, we have added several new stove lines that will give you the best selection in northwestern Pennsylvania. We now offer Harmon wood, pellet, and coal stoves manufactured right here in Pennsylvania. Yes, we are the store with more value and choices for you. Come to Warm Home and Hearth in Pleasantville. Pick out your stove, fireplace, or insert today. Yes, we have a fire burning just for you.
I've bought several trucks off of Joe here. Always got a good deal. He's very honest.
Joe's a nice guy. He's personable, but I eight cars off him.
Joe's a great guy. His service department, they're fantastic. Sales department, they'll make sure it happens for you.
Joe Taylor Ford didn't disappoint me, that's for sure.
Come on out and get a good deal.
People here are totally amazing, and I got my new car.
We're 257
in Seneca.
And welcome back. A very lively gymnasium here as the Titusville Rockets win in overtime on the senior night, 58-47. What a game.
An outstanding game. We got to see some enthusiasm at the end of that game. I know that I made mention of what I thought was a little bit of showboating by Tyler Gates, but I want to tell you what I really like is, you know, maybe I didn't really go for that, but he was excited. And it's nice to see the excitement from this program. It's just outstanding. The student section tonight came down and stormed the court right after the ball game ended and really gave a lot of support to our Titusville Rockets. And it's just a great win from them. The Rockets need one more win to guarantee at least a tie for the region title. So with next week's games on the horizon, this was a good win. We didn't want to let this one slip away.
Yeah, and they're on the road, so a tough week ahead for the Rockets.
Tough week ahead, but we overcame a lot tonight, especially from the free throw line. We just struggled all night long. But there were three things that I thought really turned this game around. One was the steal by Nate Ciccarelli right at the half court line. Took that ball in for a layup. The second one was Danny Schneider. And I feel like a broken record. I've said this a couple times already. But Schneider came through with a couple of clutch threes after having such a tough night shooting the ball tonight. And the third one was when the Rockets got a little bit of a lead. Coach Mellenbacher called for the four corners offense. And Skinner, a la Phil Ford back in the old North Carolina days, took the ball all the way to the hole for a layup. And those three things tonight I thought were the keys to help us overcome what was an 8-point lead at one time from Northeast.
Well, an exceptional game. And again, we say goodbye to the seniors here tonight. And, you know, I'm flipping through the program. And, yeah, we've got the basketball players that we know are wrapping up their season at home for regular season play. But you're saying goodbye to some of the cheerleaders and others who make this team a success this year. So we wish everyone the best of luck as they finish out their high school career over the next couple months and move on into their future.
Well, I mean, these are types of things that people always remember. The guys on the team are always going to remember this season. The cheerleaders will remember that they were a part of this because this is a program. And what's nice is when the program extends not only from to the players, but also to those around it, the support people like the cheerleaders and the stats people. And even in tonight's crowd with the parents and the students, all of them with their hearts beating rapidly as they really cheered the Rockets on to victory.
All right, again, final here, 58-47. I'm not sure what's going to happen with us in the coverage of the boys' program. It's one of those things where we just sort of wait and see what happens and develops over the next week. So looking forward to seeing what happens with the Rockets, where they're going to end up, and hopefully we can be a part of that when we can.
Well, Luke, thanks so much for having me this year. I know I'm a fill-in. I hope our buddy Jim's doing well. I appreciate you permitting me to come here and just do a lot of my jibber-jabbering to all the people.
Well, you have no idea how much we greatly appreciate your service over the last couple weeks with us. It has been a lot of fun being here, and getting your insight has been just amazing because, you know, Jim coached for a number of years, but I'm not sure if he knew what he was doing. Well, I'm joking.
I think there's a lot of people that would say the same about me.
So, Coach, thank you so much. I'll tell you what, it's been an exciting couple weeks. And, again, we'll kind of wait to see what happens and where the Rockets are going to end up in the playoff picture.
Well, let's hope for a good seed, and let's hope for another home game here at the Launchpad.
All right, again, final 58-47 for Mark High. Mark, excellent job as always, and thank you, sir, for Tim McCord doing play-by-play and just doing an outstanding job. Thank you so much. I'm Luke Rio, and our coverage of Titusville Rocket basketball all season long has been presented by Bayless Fuel Service, by State Farm Insurance, by Oil Creek Plastics, by the Colonial Machine Company, by Donovan and Bauer Auto Group, by Anderson Physical Therapy, by Big G Tire and Auto, by the University of Pittsburgh at Titusville, by Joe Taylor Ford, by Armstrong, by the American Legion, by Community Chevrolet, by Warm Home and Hearth, and by Titusville Area Hospital.